So welcome back to part two. The boys are there, just going to get some food. See what we can do in Charmouth.
How
was your ride in?
Hilly.
Good, yeah. Tell us about it. We feel like we've been climbing uphill all the way here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Jesus, not for that.
Let's ride home then.
Yeah, well hopefully it'll be downhill on the way home. Nice. It can't be uphill both ways, can it?
It's gonna be.
You know it will be. That's not bad timing actually, we've only been here 2 minutes.
Have you really?
Yeah.
Oh man. We were saying we think it's gonna be on time,
isn't it? Chicken nuggets and chips.
I was gonna say, you've been talking about chips for the last 10 miles. Oh, they've got a cappuccino. So when you come to the seaside, you've got to have chips, haven't you? So, is that what you call carp loading, Pete?
It's all good.
Yeah, it always tastes better at the seaside.
Definitely, yeah.
I don't know why.
Andy, Sam, welcome to the vlog.
Hiya,
thank you. How was your ride here?
Really hilly.
You can't avoid it down this way.
How far was it?
About 30k or something.
How many metres of climbing?
No, it's basically, you go, well, we took the coastal road, so you lose elevation every time. You come down into a little down and straight back up.
Yeah. So instead of going on the A road, you went on the B roads.
Yeah.
Where did you come through?
So I came through Beer, Branscombe, Seaton, then upline through to here. So I live just 20 miles away because that's how far I've ridden. And planning the route out last night just made me realise why I don't come this sort of direction because it's so hilly.
How far was it for you, Sam?
Well, you see,
did you cheat?
I went out and got a lift to Andy's house. So it turned what would have been a 90k ride into a 60k ride for me.
Sorry.
Yeah, no shame.
And the bike, someone tell us about? Andy, can you tell us about your bike?
Well, so this is relatively new for me. Got this in February, so I've been riding a bit, so it's been my lockdown friend. So this is...
Spanking new 105 derail, I've got the tools.
Yeah, should we just steal that one off?
when he's not looking.
That one looks straight.
Slightly inspired by last time I went over to Mallorca and rode some bikes a little bit like this. So I thought it'd be nice to treat myself to a bit of a summer bike. So I've got my other giant, so you can see I'm quite brand loyal, which I'm riding to work and keeping as a bit of a winter bike, but this is my summer treat.
So how far you spent all this money on this bike and you've got these?
Yeah.
You can't do that. And Sam? You want to tell us about your bike?
Well, today I'm riding my little brother's Dawes Century SE. So, tell us how heavy that is, Darren.
That's about 15 kilograms.
Yeah. It's about 5 years old, but I've come back from London for lockdown and my bike is still up there. So I've got to make do with...
Make do with what you got?
What we've got.
Look how small the cassette is on the back.
23.
What even is that? Triple chain rings? That's cheating, isn't it?
Yeah.
The back end is so heavy.
The wheels make big, they're obviously steel frame as well. And a sore group set, it's not the lightest.
I think you need a medal just for coming on it.
Yeah, apparently.
I've got to get back first.
That's a workout picking up. See that?
Bit of play in it.
Yes, just a little bit.
That's giving you automatic gear selection, Pete. Just choosing which gear he wants you to be in.
It was a bit frightening when I took my hands off the handlebars and it changed gear. On the way here.
No, we had a debate about that. I don't like crossovers, so we made a nice big loop.
Making sure the route doesn't cross over at any point, so it's like a big loop.
It's a profile downhill on the way back, Pete.
Oh,
No. You see, they did ice creams.
I did. I said I would have chips and an ice cream bar. I'm so full.
Find an ice cream van on the way home.
We are going through Broad Windsor.
That's a chance, yeah.
Which might have a little cafe.
Yeah. Pete, yeah. You like your gravel riding so much, when are you going to have a go on the beach?
No, I need a fat bike for that.
A fat bike? Got some chunky tyres on there.
No, I'm not doing that for YouTube.
So you're panicking about getting home before it starts then, Pete?
Yeah, I've still got 50 miles to go.
It's only 50 miles, Sunday ride.
Yeah, I've already done 40 to get here.
Yeah, it's good to meet you, boys.
Yeah,
enjoy your ride back.
Thanks for coming across and seeing us.
It's a good day out.
Yeah, it can't be that hilly on the way back, surely. It can't be. What was the overall meters of climbing, Pete?
I think it was like 1500.
Oh, so it can't be then. We've done 800. We've got 700 to go. Right, so we're going to make our way back now to Glastonbury. Pete's going to peel off just before then as well. He's got 80k, I've got about 60k, so a little bit less, but there we go. Behind the scenes of the gram.
Yeah, Instagram. Men of CC.
Follow us.
Back now.
Yeah. So you boys are going right up the hill.
Yeah.
We're going left. Downhill!
200 metres.
Celebrate every inch downhill. That's the end of part two. We will see you again in a couple of minutes or tomorrow for part three, which is the ride home. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. That's not good.
That's less than ideal, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you're open until midday on a Sunday.
I've got a horrible feeling I've been this way before.
That doesn't sound good.
And we're climbing up there. We've just hit 1,000 metres and we've got to go up there.
And we're both out.
Still, it's probably down all the way home, isn't it? You're not going to believe what we've just found.